I know, guys. I know, okay? I know y'all probably wondering, where the fuck is the Ruby Reactions? Where the fuck is the Borderlands 2 freaking walkthrough, which I keep promising all the damn time, especially Borderlands 2? And I know that all of you guys are gonna be like, dude, you keep making accusations of a blah. Like, dude, I'm not making accusations. Why make up another one? I don't do that. Every time I bring that thing back up saying I am gonna freaking do it, you guys are gonna be like,
why the fuck you lying?
Why
you always lying? Oh my god, stop fucking lying.
But no worries. It's because I've been playing some Sword Art Online Holorealization. Not only that, but basically all fucking day yesterday, too. I just needed to beat this game. I needed to. That's how far I was making, the progress I was making. I was like, fuck yeah, let's get this done. And for the first time of the video, y'all know what it is. It's fucking Dragon Age. Dragon Age ain't. I don't say Dragon Age Inquisition. What the hell am I talking about? Dragon Age Origins. Easily my favorite game from BioWare to date. I find it better than the Mass Effect trilogy. Well, not really the Mass Effect trilogy combined, but better than the first Mass Effect and Mass Effect 2. That's saying a lot. I find it better than Mass Effect 3 because I love Mass Effect 3 just as much as I love 1 and 2. And for what I've been playing from Inquisition, because I did play Inquisition, but the thing is, I'm playing a lot of Origins now that I possibly want to start over my Inquisition story because it's been so long since I played it. And I'm not gonna transition my choices from Origins to fucking Inquisition that I gotta go on a fucking website to do. But Dragon Age Origins. What can I say about it? Now, Dragon Age Origins, BioWare's best game, even if it is 8 years old. What's so good about the game? Well, find out in this review of this very dark, like, I'm talking about, like, fucking Tokyo Ghoul type of seriousness. 2003 Full Metal Alchemist series. Combine that shit, and that's what you get. Combine both of those serious animes, like the seriousness in them, and you got fucking Dragon Age.
Now let me open the door. Don't get uncomfortable. Niji ni kuno watashi to mitatsu.
Now, again, I'm gonna try and make this review as short as possible, try and get everything done right off the bat without making this long. I'm gonna have to make this long. I'm gonna make a part two to make everybody happy. Okay? So, I won't really waste everybody's time here. Now, Dragon Age Origins. Why I think it's BioWare's best game is because right off the bat, you're into a character customization when you start up the game, and you get to customize the character. Not only you get to customize the character, but you also get, like, you know, male or female, you know, like always, you know, it's kind of like Mass Effect. Not only that, we actually get to choose its origin story. Now I know in Mass Effect it didn't really have an origin story. I mean, there was a bit of context that did come to play a bit later in the game, especially if you pick the Mendwar, backstory in Mass Effect 1. Like, there's a little mini side quest regarding that to your character, which kind of is really cool. And it's a, but in Dragon Age Origins, you actually, depending on how you customize your the main features of your character and stuff, when you get into it, it will depend on your origin story, whether you'll be a mage or a human noble, an elf, a dwarf noble, or whatever. And it is such a fantastic game. Now, I haven't played through all the origin stories, but I do kind of plan to, but that's just all only once. So I'm going through the rest of the game again, to be honest. Because if I'm going to be honest with you, the game is pretty hard in my personal opinion. Especially the later shit. I'm looking at you, Loghain, Broodmother. Fucking wolves in the Brazilian forest. I'm looking at you. But now, I would go on about how hard the game is to me, and I know people are going to be calling bullshit at me. Because I've been playing on fucking casual, which is what I've always played on when it comes to BioWare games. Because I want to enjoy their stories. Now, I could go on about that, but we're going to be talking about Dragon Age Origins, the actual game. Now, depending on which origin story you take, it depends on how the Grey Warden, Duncan, meets up with you. Now, I chose the most popular route, where if you begin as like a human noble and you go to like the shit around in Ausgard at the beginning of the game, your character is basically going through some Game of Thrones shit. I mean, your origin story is basically about your family getting murdered and you deal with even more bloody murder around the beginning of the game. Because it does start off very, very dark. And especially at the time that this game was made, it was on some Game of Thrones shit. I'm not gonna lie. So now, after the events at Ostagar, which you do become a Grey Warden, which you are a Grey Warden, you're with another Grey Warden named Alistair, who also survived those events, and a witch named Morgan, who is the daughter of the witch Flemeth, that of the witch Flemeth that actually helps you a bit in the, again, that is kind of involved of your survival. Now, it for a certain purpose that does come into play much later. I know I'm kind of tensing it up. I'm trying to get everybody interested because if you all have not played Dragon Age Origins, I highly recommend going out and buying it because it is some of the best, it has some of the best storytelling you'll ever see with characterization and everything. Even if the game is like 8 freaking years old, it still holds up when it comes to its writing and characterization. Now, you do gain, now like any other BioWare game, you do get more companions as you go along. Now, in Lothering, if you're not there for a while, the dark, I'm gonna be honest with you, the Darkspawn are gonna overtake that shit. You will not be able to get like an additional Quinari squad member which you can release, and if you don't pick up a certain other squad member that's also there too, Liliana, and because I highly recommend doing that because that's what the hell I did, and because I just randomly stood up upon another character which is also named Liliana, and I because of her I got this dude out which is named Sten, which both characters are freaking cool. Like, even though Stan may disagree with me a lot because of how I handle things at times, he's still cool as hell. Either like, even if you pick the human noble origin story, or you got the DLC for going back to Ostagar, if you get a fucking dog, he will try if you go to speak to your dog. at a certain point at camp, Stan will literally try to like understand your dog, and it is fucking hilarious and awesome at the same time. But with all that, what else is there in the game? What's the real main plot here, dude? Well, basically, with the event of the Ostagar, Darkspawn are overtaking. You're a Grey Warrior, you're supposed to kill Darkspawn, and now that there's only two of you left in Ferelden because of the event at Ostagar, you have to. There's also, the big, the big cheese of the Darkspawn called the Archdemon, which is actually a dragon, and you do want to kill it, but the thing is, your squad and everything are just not ready yet. You have to gather armies. Well, really, before all that shit, you gotta deal with this traitorous fucker first when it comes to politics, and you have to gather air, but you still try to gain as many allies and armies as you can while trying to avoid this traitorous, this obviously traitorous bastard throughout the game, and everywhere that you go has that you go to pick up allies has a really damn good and very dark story arc to it. The Red Cliff arc was really just what was the first place where I went. Oh shit. Like, it is on some dark levels of craziness. And if you're playing as a mage in the mage origin story, a certain someone from that origin story does show up, and you're probably gonna be pissed as all hell at him. Now, again, I'm gonna be honest with you guys. No matter where you're at in the story, no matter your origin story matters, and it does a damn good job to it. Your mage origin story matters when you get the Red Cliff, and even to like, win if you actually manage to recruit her in the circle of magi arc. The Ozamar arc, where you're trying to get all the politics done and shit, and you really go to the friggin' home place of the Darkspawn, which is fucking cool as hell. In that arc, which is awesome, and which I'm pretty sure if you're playing like a dwarf noble or a commoner or something like that, you're probably gonna be related to some of that stuff, which will lead to an obvious choice in that matter. Who knows? But what I really love about Dragon Age Origins is the story arcs. Again, the Ozamar arc, awesome. Circle Magi arc, amazing. The Red Cliff arc, fucking awesome. The arc with the elven stuff, like, dude. And the damn Resilient Forest arc. Now, I know it's kind of a bit not that long in terms of story-wise, but the gameplay, yes. But again, the reason why I'm talking about the story arcs here is because this is what Dragon Age is known, Origins is known for. Now, I could go along with the gameplay, but actually, let's describe the gameplay. This is a video game. Dragon Age Origins gameplay is rather simplistic, where basically you just have to. I'm not fucking joking. You have to hold B, like you just gotta aim a target, hold A, and just keep holding it, like your character will immediately attack it. There are other characters you can play as too, which are within your squad. But I'd rather play with my own character because he's OP as fuck. But I do play with the other characters depending on like certain situations if I gotta unlock this. and getting some kick-ass loot, but that's all fun and dandy. Yeah, the combat is rather simplistic, but if you really kind of use the, you know, the, like, you know, when you hold on to this and you choose, like, which thing to do and stuff, and things, I'm going to be honest with you, if you get the handle of all the spells and you know, the cool shit your characters can do and everything, you're going to have lots of fun playing throughout the combat. Because even with the stuff that you don't have equipped, you'll still you can still use them in the and I would say the spin wheel, where you can, you know, use the, you know, where you can go to, like, your inventory, or where you go to your spells and stuff and abilities, and you can use them and stuff. You can really have a lot of fun playing that, and again, it's pretty fun when you do it. Now, if I had to really say about the combat, yes, it's rather simplistic, but kind of fun, and it does match Dragon Age, and I do really like some of the combat times. Even some of the executions that you make, especially on the ogre, Darkspawn. Rarely, it's just so badass with the executions, you know, the final blows. They can be really badass to the point, like when I saw Liliana just use her dagger and just decapitated the fuck out of this Darkspawn, it was fucking amazing. The reason why I say this is one of BioWare's best games is the reason why is because you actually have the choice to actually ask the squad mates you picked up to just leave, or even not even recruit them to begin with. And so basically you can go throughout the whole game with fucking Alistair and even more Morgan and stuff. I'm pretty sure Alistair is not, I know Alistair is not, you know, go awayable, because it does play a major part in the story much later. But yeah, you basically go throughout the game with Alistair all only, and I do not recommend doing that just so you can feel like an OP ass boss, because you're gonna need all the people you can get, and you're talking to a guy that plays it on casual difficulty. Now, I know there's an enchantment option, but for some reason, the enchantment stuff really does not work. I don't know what it is, but the game just doesn't have it work. I think there's something wrong with the disc, because I did get this game from a friend of mine, but the game's been running smoothly a lot, so I barely ran into any problems, so I don't know. So, but the enchantment stuff didn't really work for me, so I went through the entire game without using enchantment. It was hard as hell to do, though, but it was fucking worth it. But what I also can say is that not only can you, like, leave certain characters, like, you know, just like tell them to, like, fucking leave, like, go. You can also kill off certain characters, like, whenever a certain trigger happens, like, depending on, like, if, like, some will trigger, you can actually kill off the certain character, or have him slash her join you, or because of a certain choice that you make, that will trigger, you know, an event where you can actually kill off this character. Which, again, it's fucking amazing how many choices you can get to either kill off a certain character or just make him fucking leave. And, again, I know BioWare doesn't really do this anymore, because you're gonna need all the squad mates you can get, especially when it comes to between the King of the Events of Dragon Age Inquisition and Mass Effect 3 and Andromeda and Mass Effect 2 as well, which I can totally understand why they didn't put the options there. But I do hope that, you know, maybe once BioWare's done with, like, Dragon Age, because, you know, it's obvious that Dragon Age 4 is going to be the last game, if you play the Trespasser DLC, for what I heard of, because I heard it definitely sets up, the 4 game immediately. So, well, so probably when they're done in Dragon Age 4, then they want to make a new IP. I do hope they bring in some like this again, because that was it. This is when, now I know that Mass Effect 1 did have this too, where you can actually kill off a certain character, or not even recruit this certain character. Like, there's actually two characters you can actually not recruit, and it's very freaking cool. But yeah, that was Mass Effect 1. This is Dragon Age Origins. I know I'm getting off track, but Dragon Age Origins has some really great characters. The character I fell in love the most was Liliana and Wynn, because they're just awesome characters. You do find out about Wynn much later if you do recruit her. And to be honest, I'm gonna be honest, when I found out about this, I was like, oh my god, this better not fucking happen at the end of the game, I'm gonna fucking cry. Yeah, but there are some tear-jerking moments at times, because you don't even know if this character's really gonna live or die when he or she reveals this and this. The game can surprise you with lots of stuff. And just, I just fucking love this game, and I cannot deny that Dragon Age Origins is BioWare's best game. Now, despite how hard it was for me to get past the entire game without using a damn enchantment, because I don't know if it was like a bug or a glitch because of how the disc was made, maybe, I still enjoyed it overall, and you should not really play it for like the combat. Now, yes, it's bloody and pretty simplistic, but the story and the characters are in the setting and how fucking mature it is, because this shit takes you very seriously, and it does show that too in the combat. What it's also Witcher 3 shit. If you haven't played Dragon Age yet, please go out of your way to buy. Dragon Age is one of my favorite franchises now, and I do plan on playing Dragon Age 2 when I get the chance. Now, I know I have Inquisition, so y'all probably like, go play Inquisition, go like beat the rest of it. Then, I know Hawk and other like Dragon Age 2 stuff happens in Inquisition as well, leading up to that stuff. So, I will be playing Dragon Age 2 after I beat Inquisition. So I can learn like what led up to all this, because Inquisition does take place straight after 2. But Origins, this is by far the best game yet. I do hope they revisit a lot of the stuff in like a new IP, because again, if y'all have heard or even seen about like what happens in the Trespasser DLC that definitely sets up the fourth game, y'all know that the killing off option is more than likely just out of the fucking picture. Yeah, so that's that. I'm telling you guys, you can easily buy this game at GameStop for like $10 or maybe $20, even for like a pre-owned $5 game in one of their pre-owned parts for like $5, or something, you know. again, Dragon Age Origins, awesome game. I love, again, like in Mass Effect 1, I loved it, and I think it deserves a 10 out of 10 because of its story, its characters, the maturity, the setting, and just how it builds up everything. And it has some really fucking nice twists to it. There's actually two that takes place around the same time, right before you make your final march to the Archdemon. It is fucking amazing. Just go and check it out, please. It is, for me, come on. If any of y'all haven't played it yet, because, like, despite how hard it is to some people, because I'm pretty sure people are going to run into the same damn problem, because, again, the game is 8 years old, so you're possibly going to run into things that Bioware won't even fix anymore, probably, but that have, like, returned after patches. But I do recommend going out and buying it now. Well, I bought a DLC to it, like the ones that take place after the events of the game. Maybe, because I want to know more, because there is a Witch's Hunt there, and there's Awakening, which is a whole new story I heard, and there's, like, Origins has, like, a shitload of DLC, and it's fucking insane that they managed to put all that DLC for, like, one game. Damn. And I thought Dragon Age Inquisition was bad, like, you know, microtransactions when it came to that DLC, but Dragon Age Origins, go check it out if you haven't. It's Bioware's best game yet, in my personal opinion. Yeah. So, what do you guys think of Dragon Age Origins? If any of you guys have played it, did y'all like it? Did y'all love it? Did y'all hate it? Did you not like it? Did y'all thought it was decent, disappointing? What are you guys' thoughts? Let me know in the comments. Let me know, like, if you have played the game. Let me know what you thought. Think about the game too. I would like to know, because I fucking love Dragon Age. And everything else. Now, what am I going to be doing next? Borderlands 2, Ruby Reaction. Now, I'm going to be up, now once I upload this, I will be uploading Ruby Grim Eclipse review, which I actually had that recorded and processed, like, for over a week. So just letting y'all know, that video is, like, a week old, so don't be surprised if, like, I said this and this before I did this video and other things, too. Since I did beat Dragon Age Origins, and, you know, basically it's around the majority of the game and everything, I promise you guys this, that during spring break, we'll be doing Borderlands 2, at least by the night anyway, because that's, like, the best time to record a game, you know, perfectly. And I'll be doing more Ruby reactions, at least, it's like three of them today. So, or probably the entirety of Volume 3 if I'm probably am. Again, hope you guys enjoyed it. Like the video if y'all enjoyed it. Subscribe if y'all see more. Comment below what y'all think. And if y'all are new to the channel and want to see more, be sure to subscribe for more. And again, I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I will see y'all next time. Survivor.